In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brother and sister, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers, and warm welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's Gospel reading. Today, my dear friends, we are celebrating the solemnity of Christ the King. It's the 34th and the last Sunday of the liturgical year. Next Sunday will be the first Sunday of Advent, and with that we begin a new liturgical year. Let me read the Gospel reading from John chapter 18, verses 33 to 37. At that time, Pilate said to Jesus, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you say this of your own accord, or did others say it to you about me?" Pilate answered, "Am I a Jew? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingship is not of this world. If my kingship were of this world, my servants would fight that I might not be handed over to the Jews. But my kingship is not from the world." Pilate said to him, "So you are a king?" Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king. For this reason I was born, and for this I have come into the world, to bear witness to the truth. Everyone who is of the truth hears my voice." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. My dear friends, truth is often challenging and difficult. Truth can often embarrass people. Truth often makes folks uncomfortable. No wonder that people who speak the truth often end up alone. Then what is the use of speaking the truth if it brings such unfortunate results? Jesus assures us that the truth will set us free. He never really explains how. He just tells us and hopes that we will believe him. The story of the life of Jesus, my dear friends, begins with the question by a foreigner: "Where is the baby born to be the king of the Jews?" The story again ends with another question from yet another foreigner. Are you the king of the Jews? Jesus himself answers these questions when he says, "My kingdom does not belong to this world." And he continues and says, "I was born and came into the world for this one purpose, to speak about the truth. Whoever belongs to the truth listens to me." As we look around, my dear friends, our world today, one could wonder, where is this king? Where is his kingdom? We must remember what we read in John's Gospel today, where Jesus specifically said that his kingdom did not belong to this world. John implies that Pilate could not understand why Jesus had been handed over to him by the chief priests when Jesus did not claim to be the king of the Jews. Pilate may not have realized that Jesus was a threat to the authority of the temple leadership and the priestly power structure of his time. That priestly authority was placing impossible burdens on the people, whereas Jesus' ministry among the people brought hope and healing to even the least of them. Jesus' ministry brought fear to the hearts of the chief priests. But Jesus was a king, and indeed, he is still a king. He is a king who has come to judge all earthly kings and kingdoms. He is the king of heaven and earth. He is full of grace and truth. He is our champion. He fights our battle for us. He leads us to victory over Satan and sin. He sets us up to lead his kingdom on earth until he returns. His kingdom occurs when we freely choose to serve him. This is in contrast to a worldly kingdom where power is obtained by self-centeredness and self-esteem. Daniel's vision, my dear friends, in the first reading of today, chapter 7, verses 13 to 14. Describes the victory of Jesus as King of the universe, as he is given dominion, glory, and kingship by the Ancient One. All peoples, nations, and languages would serve him, and his kingdom would never be destroyed. Here we see a little better what Jesus meant when he said that his kingdom was not of this world. His kingship would be timeless and everlasting, and his kingdom would include all of us. And because it is timeless, his people, including us, are to live out his kingdom in our lives. Christ, our King, loves us. He died for us and shares with us whatever he possesses. He gave us the supreme proof of his love when he died for us on the cross. Kings in the world send their soldiers to fight, and if need be, to die for them. No king ever thought of going to fight himself in order to spare his soldiers. Jesus did precisely this, and the thought of his love without limit has moved millions of Christians to live and die in order to establish Christ's kingdom on earth. It is enough to have a look at ourselves and consider what we once were and what we are today. Today's second reading, my dear friends, from the book of Revelations, chapter 1, verses 5 to 8, presents Jesus as a king of love. It refers to the supreme kingship of Christ, who founded a kingdom for us. In this kingdom, he has made us persons dedicated to the service of God, his Father. Let us pray. My dear friends, as we find in the Bible diary, today Gracie Rita Vas from Kundapur is celebrating her 80th birthday. A great blessing from God, as we thank God for the gift of life that is given to Gracie Rita Vas. We pray for God's choicest blessings on her. It's also the wedding day of John and Amy D'Souza from Mumbai. Congratulations, John and Amy. May God bless your family life. We remember all our personal intentions, intentions of our donors, our well-wishers, sponsors of Bible Diary, those who have sent their prayer requests. Father, grant that we may experience the power of Christ the King and live faithfully the values of His kingdom in our daily lives. Amen. Have a wonderful Sunday, my dear friends, and wish you a happy feast of Christ the King. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is Father Stephen Pereira. If you have any problem in receiving this audio in time, kindly WhatsApp me your full name and place. My number is 91, that's the code, 94812-63229. I repeat, 94812-63229. I will be sending the audio on previous night itself. Have a great day. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow.